Okay, very good morning, my dear students. Very good morning, my dear students. So today we are going to conduct one of the basic electrical experiment. So the title, I think you already noted down what all the experiments are there. Half of the cycle which is completed. So in the second cycle, we have an experiment called measurement of resistance and inductance of choke coil using three voltmeter method. This is the kit. You can see here again the title was given in the kit. It is measurement of resistance and inductance of choke coil using three voltmeter method. So first I will tell you what are all the components are present in the kit, because you are all familiar with the circuit diagram. You can see the manual. Everything is clearly given. You can see the source, which is represented with LNN. So this is a single phase AC source. Then we have a two pin MCB, miniature circuit breaker. Then we have a another device, we call it as a variac. Then we have a 3 voltmeter, it is represented with V1, V2, V3, and the rating which is specified as 0 to 300 for all the three cases. And the end part, you can see here, I think you are all familiar with the representation. We call that as one is resistor, another one is a inductor. So this combination of R and L, we call it as choke coil. So now I will show the kit how exactly it looks. See, every time we used to say write the circuit diagram very neatly, because if you are very clear with the circuit diagram, the same connections we are going to do it with a kit. So once again I will repeat. So that is a supply, AC supply single phase. So from that, next we have a two pin MCB. So next to MCB we have a device that is called variac. We can call that as single phase auto transformer, or else it is represented as variac here. So we can vary this variac from 0 to 230. So it is variable, it is not fixed. So we can vary from 0 to 230. You can see here, it is rotatable. But initially, whenever you start an experiment, it should be always in zero position. You have to check it. So next, again for the representation, it is given 230 volt, 50 hertz. Frequency standard we have 50 hertz. Then represented with L, N. Then as we shown voltmeters V1, V2, V3. So where we have extra meters? This is inbuilt meters. You can see here V1, V2, V3. So we are going to connect this voltmeter across the system. V1 across this point, V2 across this point, and V3 across this point. And choke coil, again we have an inbuilt. Due to some issue, we are using external choke coil. So everyone is familiar, right, this choke coil? So choke coil we are using in fluorescent lamps. So this choke coil, this R and L value we are going to determine here, and we are going to connect choke coil externally for this experiment. So now I am going to show you how to do the connection. So first, always whenever you do a connection, it should be from series. Start from live wire, then connect it to load, then come back to the neutral portion. So first, MCB is all internally connected. I am not going to do any connection here. So check variac is in zero position or not. Zero position is there. Then we'll start L, that is the live connection. Just see here, L, which is connected to what? First to voltmeter. So this is voltmeter connection is given upside. So keep it there. Then we have to connect voltmeter across the system, first to voltmeter. You can see here V1, and here also representation V1. So we'll connect voltmeter across the system, V1. So we have a two ports, right? Plus and minus. You can take color representation with red and black, or else whichever the wire is available, you can take it up. So V1 connected across the system. Second voltmeter is what? V2. V2 you connect it across the second voltmeter. You can see here. Then the third connection, V3, we will connect. V3 we have connected. But see, if it is inbuilt, choke coil will be available here. But we are doing externally. You can see here, two wires as usual. You can use any two port, this or this, no issues. You can connect any of this point. So I'll connect it here. So choke coil is connected. Then the final connection is back to your neutral position. So V1 other end, it should be connected to neutral. So this is very simple connection. Once again, you see MCB, variac, then fine, L2, voltmeter 1, then choke coil. Externally, you are doing only these two connections. Then V1, V2, V3 are connected across. Across in a sense, parallelly you can connect. By mistake, if your kit is not going to work for this modules, V1, V2, V3, you can take externally one voltmeter with a range of 0 to 300. With 1 meter itself, you can run all the three voltmeters ready. Clear? So, okay, now we'll go for a reading. See, the main purpose of doing this experiment is we need to find out the value of R and L. So, here they are given a formula. R is equals to Z into cos phi. What is this cos phi? That is a power factor. And L, I think you already know the standard formula. XL is equals to, what is that? 1 by 2 pi FL. So, if you are going to calculate, L is equals to XL by 2 pi F. And one more thing, the resistor standard value, have to take it for calculating the system. Because here it is given Z is equals to V3 divided by V2 by R standard. R standard is 400 ohm, that you have to take it for calculation purpose. So in this, we are just taking a reading. You can see the tabular column, main purpose. See V1, V2, V3. You can take minimum 3 to 4 different readings. And for that, you are going to do the calculation. And that specify what is the actual value of R and L for this choke coil. Okay, we'll go for a reading. So here see, as I said, this variac can be varied from 0 to 270 it is given. But as we know that the single phase value will be 0 to 230. So we'll divide the 230 as 3 to 4 parts. So I'll just consider as 50, 50, 50, 50. So up to 200. I'm not crossing the limit of 230. So we'll take the values from 50, 100, 150 and 200. So for that you can consider the V1 as a reference. So here you can set the value as 50, 100, 150. So now what we'll do, we'll see the condition, we'll switch on the main power supply. Then second one is switch on your MCB. Once you switch on, see all the meters are reading or not. That 4 decibels, whatever the digits is available, it should be visible. If it is any problem, you should have a correction that you can have extra meters, or else once again you switch off this MCB and try one more time. So first we'll take the first reading. As I said, we'll set the first voltmeter reading as 50. So you set the value as 50. You can see the changes. Okay, only concentrate on first. Don't think about second and third. Whatever the readings you are getting, let it be on the record book. So approximately we are getting, okay, I'm getting 50.82. So you can make fine adjustment also. Let it be. So I'm getting 49.98. So almost 50. You can take 51 also, no issue. Okay. So for this 50, a first V1 reading, V2 is 30, V3 is 32. Note down those readings. Okay. So second case, I'll just increase the value of V1 to 100. Okay, so I'm getting 100.6 or 101, no issues. The second reading is 60, third reading is 67. Note down this reading also. Is it clear, right, the readings are? Okay, then we'll go to the third one. 150 I'll keep. So 150, so exactly I got 150. So for 151, again we are getting a value of V2 as 89, V3 as 101. So the last reading I'll go for 200. Okay, so 200, 203 I'm getting, we'll make a fine adjustment. So we are getting 200. So for this, we're getting V2 as 120 and V3 as 134. This is the only the readings taken part. So in the kit, you're going to take 4 readings. So once you finish this, because from this you cannot identify or find out the actual values of R and L. You have to go for the calculation, then only you can determine what is the actual RL value of a choke coil. So once you've done this, then you have to go back or bring back this variac to zero position. Just see, bring back this variac to zero position. Slowly you have to do it. So once it come back to zero, next switch off the MCB, then switch off the main supply. So after that only you have to remove the connection. So here I have one trial version values. You can see here
So your values, it is taken as 54, 100, 150. The three readings has been taken, and for that corresponding V2 and V3 values are existing. So first you have to find out power factor. Everyone knows, right? What is power factor? It is the cosine of an angle between voltage and current. And whenever we use a term called inductor, it always specified as a lagging power factor. So then find out Z value. Why we are considering Z? It is a combination of R and L. It is not a pure inductor or pure resistor. It is a combination of R and L, so that we are going to calculate Z. So that is V3 divided by V2 divided by R standard. As I said, R standard is from the manual, you take the value as 400 because it is inbuilt, which is taken up as 400. That's what you use that for calculation. Then from that you calculate R, Z into cos phi, you'll get some value, that is our resistance. And XL, XL is what? Reactive inductance. Reactive inductance, they are given a formula, square root of Z square minus Z into cos phi whole square. So if you do this calculation, you get some values. From this, you can calculate L easily. So from the overall, you can represent L will be 1.42, 1.5, 1.5. So average, if I take these three, we can say the inductance value is 1.5 and the resistance is approximately between 250 ohms. So from this kind of experiment, we can determine the inductive load specification. This choke coil is one of the inductive load what we are using in your daily appliances. We are using washing machine, we are using fan, we are using tube light. Is it what type of load? Being an electrical student or being an electrical systems, we should know what type of load, and this choke coil comes under inductive load. Okay.